Are you ready to stop the self-sabotage and create the life you desire? Well, in order for that to happen, you need to break free from the bad beliefs that are holding your success hostage. You need to optimize the stress by turning it into extra energy for success. And those hurtful habits? Well, we need to give that pain a purpose for progress. Welcome to Stop the Self-Sabotage and Create the Life You Desire podcast. Did you put a demand on yourself this morning to get up and be physically active when really all you wanted to do was take a few moments of quiet and get ready for your day before you jumped into the mayhem? What did you ask of yourself, and what does it have to do with how frequently you will self-sabotage during the day or step up into success? See, the studies have shown that whenever you put yourself into a physically demanding position early in the day, that it actually resets your autonomic nervous system to be able to handle stress later on in the day in a way that is actually going to be healthier and more functional. Now, this doesn't necessarily mean exercise, but it does mean getting out there and asking something of your body that you'd really rather not do. I don't necessarily want to be playing soccer at 6 o'clock in the morning with a 150-plus-pound dog in the dark. I'm playing soccer by flashlight. And it's because, well, Thor can't go for walks. If you've been in my world for a while, you know my puppy is an epileptic. And I was told not quite a year ago, don't ever take him any place that if he were to have a seizure, you can't get him out on your own. And in the dark, on a walking path, not an ideal situation that if something should happen, I'd be able to get him out. And taking a walk is so much easier than trying to find a soccer ball by flashlight and then chasing my dog around with it. But I know by doing that, it can be for as little as 10 minutes. I am recalibrating. I am resetting my autonomic nervous system to be able to handle stress. And there's two types of stress. There's distress. And there's eustress, and the eustress is spelled E-U in the word stress. What's interesting is it can be the same situation, but two different people see it differently. One is going to slide down into coping of just surviving, and then to make themselves feel better a little bit later on, they're going to self-sabotage with the twos. Too much eating, too much drinking, too much smoking, too much shopping, too much bitching, moaning, whining, and complaining. To where the other who sees it as eustress because they've put a demand on their system to perform earlier in the day when they'd rather not. Well, that system says, okay, I can take this stress and actually use it to up level. Because success has a high threshold. It's going, you got to come up to my level. Self-sabotage, you can slide right on into it. But there's something else that happens. It's what's known as procedural memory. This is the part of you that remembers skills and actions to be able to get goals. Now, the goal doesn't have to be something progress-oriented. If the goal is to numb yourself out, the procedural memory will hold the skill set of the twos, and you'll just slide right on into it. But it goes up also into progress. And this is where it's like, oh, I got this extra energy. Let's use it to get more done in less time. With less effort. And when you have an awareness, so there's knowledge, wisdom, and then awareness. A lot of people, you listen to this podcast. Okay, great. You've got knowledge, but it doesn't do you any good unless you act on it. And when you act on it, you find how it needs to be customized to fit you and your unique experience, your unique identity, personality. And you do that through failure. And then you say, okay, well, this is what worked, and this is what will make it even better. And that's wisdom. But if you repeat that wisdom often enough, the procedural memory turns into awareness, and awareness can never be taken away from you. I learned some math skills whenever I was in school. I've never used them. They're gone. Did not remember them. But riding a bike, driving a car, communicating in a way with those that I care about, where it's heartfelt, that's awareness. And no matter what, you can never take that away from me. I can be off of a bike for decades and get back on one and go, it's going to take me a little bit, but I've got that awareness. It's going to come back. You already have an awareness on how to self-sabotage. That can never be taken away from you. What if we upgrade it, though, and say, yeah, there's stress, but that stress can be turned into eustress by putting a demand on yourself. There's another component to it, though. You have to get subconscious agreement where it understands that the pattern you're setting up is for progress, not more pain. And if I can assist you with that, reach out. We'll have a complimentary coaching call. So when you get up in the morning, as soon as possible, put yourself in a position where you have to do something physically. Get active, even though you don't want to, and do a reset on your set point so that your system now understands that it's programmed for progress.